Okay, round five. Currently 4-0. Hopefully we can close it out and get a nice 5-0. This is a decent hand. Our opponent opting to go with the second main phase Thraben Inspector. Oh no, it's okay. Town Gossip Monger. I mean, I'm definitely gonna shoot it. We'll see. Because I cannot deal with a 2-3. Alright, let's go ahead and just get that bombardment off the board. Okay, so it's another Thalia's Lieutenant. I'm just firing this off on anything. My opponent's clearly got another play here. That is not a human. Nice. Alright, our opponent is basically all in, but our hand isn't very good. But, I mean, we had a 1, 2, and 3 play, so we cannot really complain here. So this turn, I'm hoping my opponent's out of gas. Because I really wanted to cast Glimmer of Genius. But now I feel like I should anticipate. Because I have a lot of... Let's see, I have a lot of interaction here. I mean, but Glimmer just gets me ahead, and then I can probably deal with everything else. No, I should probably cast Glimmer. Because, like, it's not... I'm not guaranteed... First of all, I'm at a pretty high life total. Secondly, I'm not guaranteed to hit something off the Anticipate. Glimmer digs me deeper. Huh. Don't want the Fumarole. Do I want the Glimmer? I don't think so. Because I'm already... Like, I already have an Anticipate and a Gear Hulk. I really just want to find action. This was not action. We're gonna take 6 here. That's gonna suck. Alright, well. Ugh. This is crazy. We had like the perfect curve, and this is still going to be close. Let me think. So I can Jace bounce, Toolcraft Exemplar, and then Galvanic Bombardment the Copter. That seems pretty good. Because it's the second bombardment. I bounce this one because obviously it can just bash me for 3. All right. We are being attacked. Okay. Stabilize, maybe? Again, don't really want Glimmer. This is going to be the old Gear Hulk bombardment turn. Actually, if my opponent plays like an artifact, I might just counter that. Although my opponent might be tempted to just activate Shambling Vent and bash me, because it looks like they're out of gas here. Okay. It looks like Stasis Snare, maybe. Alright, well, regardless, I'm just gonna run this out. Bombardment. Not actually sure which to kill. Oh, who am I kidding? So my opponent can tap this and give me the beatdowns, but I think that's okay. Like, I can just counter all the other stuff. And I can bounce the constable if I really have to. And also, this deck doesn't really have a whole lot of reach. Declaration in stone. Let's go ahead and negate that. Attack me for one. Okay, no. I just got too much on the board here. Okay. So got game one, which is huge because this matchup is not good. They are very, very aggressive. Let's bring in Incendiary Flows, Thing in the Ices, Kozlek's Returns. Let's take out all the expensive stuff. I mean, I don't want any counters, but let's see. I gotta keep some in, and the cards that I'm most concerned about in the matchup are, like, Always Watching is very good, Gideon is good, they usually bring in Gideon and, like, Transgress the Minds. Like, the creatures, I don't really care too much about countering, so I think I might just want all negates. Could also play some rebuffs, something like this, just all 2-mana stuff. I don't really want 3-mana counters in this matchup. Yeah. Yeah, this seems okay. Dragon Master Outcast again. They're a little too fast, so boarding in Dragon Master Outcast is like the equivalent of boarding in like more 6 drops, which is not really what you want to do. It does trade sometimes. I have faith that I'm going to draw like an island because I don't want to just use the hubs for blue mana, but you know, we got to turn 2 Thing in the Ice. Oh, perfect. Got to turn 2 Thing in the Ice. Oh. The nuts. Oh, no land? Okay. Oh! My opponent just tilt scooped. That's the thing with the white weenie deck. Sometimes you just gotta keep those one landers and hope to get there. But bam! 5-0. Did not expect that. You know, I said the reason to play this blue-red deck was to basically beat on Marvel and Panharmonicon, but we actually ended up playing against like a bunch of creature decks. We played against 2 blue-white flash decks, a white weenie deck, and that green-white humans deck as well. So as you can see, you still have game. I'm not gonna lie, I got pretty lucky. I drew well. I mean, look at our first game in this match where I went turn 1 bombardment, turn 2 counter your thing, turn 3 counter your thing, turn 4 spell. And that's not always the case. But again, this is the reason to play blue-red because you do have access to bombardment. Bombardment is fantastic against all these creature decks, and that's something that's lacking in, for example, like the blue-black deck, which I think the blue-black deck is a better deck if you're looking to play against you know, the slower decks of the format. You know, I think blue-black has a better game against green-black because of the Ruinous Paths. It has better game against Marvel because you have access to Transgress. But bombardments, you can't really replace bombardment in anything that the other control decks have. But I think there are, you know, a lot of this is completely metagame dependent, and we just ended up getting paired against a lot of aggro matchups. But thank you for watching, folks. 5-0 with the blue-red, standard blue-red Dynavolt Tower control deck. As you can see, I just really enjoy playing this deck. It's really just right down my alley, just say and go, playing around everything that my opponent can have, and then just squeezing out some very, very close victories. So until next week, I will see you all around.